Hello guys, in this video tutorial we'll be talking about a very important as well as interesting topic about the plant tissue culture, which is the somatic embryogenesis. Now, as the name suggests, embryogenesis means the development and production of embryo from the zygotic cells. Normally, what we know about the embryo, that male and female gamete will come and meet with each other. They will form the zygote, which is a 2n in number, 2n number of chromosome, and then zygote will develop to form the embryo. But in this case, the previous term somatic suggests us that this embryo is made with somatic cells, not the cells of germline, that means not the cell of male and female gametes, but from the ordinary somatic cell line cells. That makes this topic much more interesting. Now, as we know that plants are having the enormous capability of providing the totipotency, that means from one plant cell it can generate the whole living plant. Okay, so again in this case the somatic means from the ordinary plant tissue the cell is generated. No endosperm or seed coat is formed around the somatic embryo. Remember these things. No endosperm and seed coat is formed around the somatic embryo, while in other cases the embryo produced from the germline cells will be covered by the seed coat and it will produce the seed, which is hard. Applications of this somatic embryogenesis is clonal propagation of genetically genetically uniform plant material, and second thing is the elimination of viruses we can do with this. And also this somatic embryogenesis can be done with the help of some distinctly related plant species that cannot be mated via the normal mating process or sexual reproduction of plant, so we can do this somatic embryogenesis in those cases. Okay. Now, we can generate a whole plant from a single cell called the protoplast with the help of the somatic embryogenesis. This is another very important application. Now, development of synthetic seed technology is also based on this somatic embryogenesis. That means you produce this embryo via the somatic cells, and those embryo is being coated via the synthetic chemical components, which will act as a synthetic seed, and we can utilize those seed, we can implant those seed, and those seed can form fully functional plants. Okay, so as we know, the plant growth regulates in the tissue culture medium can be manipulated to induce the callus formation, because callus is undifferentiated cell growth. If you don't know what is callus and what is callus culture, you just go back to my channel and look for the basics of plant tissue culture. You will find all these things, then go back then come back and see this video. Okay. The ratio of different plant growth regulators required to induce the callus, and that can vary from one plant to another plant, and that will help sometimes to provide the shoot, sometimes it will help to provide the root, sometimes it will help to grow the callus in huge amount. Okay, and it will produce this whole plant from the cell. Now, embryo have some features. What are the features? That the embryo has a bipolar axis, that means it is having the polarity. So both of the end are not similar, they are varying. So this end and this end are different than each other. This is the embryo stained with this dye. This is the rice embryo, and this is stained with dye. Now you can find here that it is a bipolar, so these two polars are different, and it is having a shoot meristem at one end and root meristem at another end. As you can see in this picture, this end are the shoot meristem and these are the root meristem of the rice. And it also have the hypocotyles in the middle. So these are the hypocotyles on the middle, and it stores some food as endosperm, as you can see in this case. So all of the type of fruits and foods whatever we are eating, like this rice, so this middle region, or fruits and all these things, whatever are tasty for us, we are eating all the time, are the preserved food for the embryo, preserved food for the developing and nourishment of the embryo inside the fruit, as element of a seed. It is called the endosperm. Okay, and it also must have the cotyledons, which will cover this, and also have the seed coat at surrounding this whole structure. Okay, so these are the features of embryo, the normal embryo, or the zygotic embryo rather. Okay, now types of embryo, there are two types of embryo, three types of mainly two types, like zygotic embryo and non-zygotic embryo. Zygotic embryo means the embryo which is formed due to the formation of zygote, which is mediated by the gamete, male and female gamete fission. Okay, fusion. And non-zygotic embryos can be further divided into three stages. One is somatic embryo, parthenogenetic embryo, and the androgenic embryo. Somatic embryos mean those formed by the sporophytic cells, except for zygote formation in vivo or in vitro any condition. Parthenogenetic embryos are those formed by unfertilized egg. So if egg which is already formed, but from that egg we are producing the embryo, no need for the male gamete in that case. So unfertilized egg can develop to embryo, is called the parthenogenetic embryo. In the same way, we are having the androgenic embryo. The androgenic embryo means those formed from the male gametes, like the microspore, like the pollen grains. These are the male parts. From this male gametes or male gametophyte regions, we can have the formation of fully functional plants without the importance or without being needed, without the need for any kind of female embryo in this case. Okay. Now, embryogenesis. What is embryogenesis? The plant embryogenesis refers to the process of development of plant embryos from the zygote. This is called the zygotic embryogenesis. If the development of embryo is done from the somatic cell, it will call the somatic embryogenesis. The embryogenesis may occur naturally in the plant as a result of sexual fertilization, and these embryos are called the zygotic embryos and developed into seeds, which can germinate and give rise to seedlings. Now, plant cells can also be induced to form embryos in plant tissue culture. Okay, we can also utilize it to form the plant, to produce a mature plant utilizing the plant tissue culture. Okay, so this is a picture of the normal embryogenesis, a zygotic embryogenesis rather. So this is the zygote, which is having the 2n number of chromosomes. This is the apical region, this is the basal polar region. Then it will start to produce a globular like structure, which is the very first step of the embryogenesis. In the second step is a production of heart shaped structure, heart shaped embryo. Now in this case we are having this region, and then the root is formed in this region, stem is forming from the this region, and then the heart shaped embryo will form into a mature torpedo shaped embryo. Now this torpedo shaped embryo will further be converted into the mature embryo, where you having the apical meristematic region. This tissue will divide very rapidly to produce a shoot, and this is the root apical meristem from where the root will be generated. Now somatic embryogenesis. When embryos regenerate from somatic cells or tissues which are haploid and diploid, both can be done, it is termed as the somatic embryogenesis. Now somatic embryogenesis is a process by which the somatic cells or tissues develops into the differentiated embryos. Now somatic embryogenesis was first induced in suspension culture, cell suspension culture. That means we are having the suspension, a liquid medium onto the cell, plant cells are suspended. From there on, the cells will start to divide and grow and grow, and finally it will produce a mature plant. Okay, it will produce a callus, then you take those callus onto and place them into the rooting medium, then sometimes place them into the shooting medium, and then the root and shoots start to come out. Then you take them and the mature plant is developed, you take the plant and implant them in the soil. So that's how the actual process of cell suspension culture actually work. You can look for cell suspension culture in detail. I have a video on cell suspension culture in my channel too. Okay. Now, the somatic embryogenesis or SE occurs most frequently in tissue culture as an alternative organogenesis for regeneration of whole plant. Normally, what happens if you utilize the tissue culture, like the body cell tissues, like root culture or shoot culture, root tip and shoot tip most of the times, then leaf culture and all these things, and bud culture, we can generate a full plants. But this is an alternative technique going against all those different patterns I've told you, that this is the alternative pathway of generating a whole plant or generating the organs of a plant, which is organogenesis, to produce a whole plant, right? Now, stages of somatic embryogenesis. First stage is the induction. The induction can be done utilizing different enzymes and also different chemical factors which are instigating the development of the embryo. Then the development comes from globular to heart shape, then to torpedo shape, then finally the germination occurs, root and shoot are developed. Okay. Now these are the stages. Globular stages, embryo is small and round shaped, which is also multicellular. Heart shaped means it is a bilateral symmetry formation. So shape changes to heart shape with more cotyledon development, it will change its shape into heart shape. A cotyledon is formed and also the endosperm will start to form. Then the torpedo shaped stage is done, which is consists of initial cells for the shoot and root meristem formation, and then finally the mature stage, which is the production of embryo, and the embryo becomes cylindrical and the embryo will grow, and we can take this embryo, it will mature into the plant, then we can take the plant and implant them into the soil. Okay. Now this is the induction medium. This kind of induction media of embryogenesis can vary from one type of plant to another type of plant, but generally the induction medium as follows. Like it must have the production of auxin, because auxin is important for cell division, and also the presence of cytokinin in very first amount, because cell differentiation and division is triggered by cytokinin hormone. So we have auxin, and 2,4-D is type of auxin, or naphthalene acetic acid can be utilized for this purpose. Then the development. Auxin must be removed for embryo development. It's a continuous use of auxin inhibits the embryogenesis. That's another important part, that if we continuously supplying the auxin, that what we will do, because it will suppress the growth of apical meristem and instigate the growth of apical meristem and suppress the growth of axillary buds. So as a result, the tree, my tree or our tree will go very thin and tall, but we don't always want that. We must want the tree which is also having branch regions. So we, after some time of activity of auxin, we suppress the auxin activity and give cytokine in place of auxin. Okay, endocytokinin and also the gibberellin sometimes are given, because it is helping the development of the embryo. Now stages are similar to the zygotic embryogenesis, like globular, heart-shaped, torpedo, then cotyledonary, then the germination stage. Okay. Then finally the maturation. It requires the complete maturation with apical meristem, radical and cotyledons. It often obtained repetitive embryonic can be obtained, and storage protein production is necessary during this position. And the final time of maturation, we must give the abscisic acid, because the abscisic acid production is important during the maturation, which can act as a signaling molecule into the plant to finally germinate the seed. Okay. Then these are the picture of the embryogenesis. As you can see, this is the globular shape, then heart shaped, then torpedo shaped, then finally the matured cotyledonary stage, and right after that it will germinate and root and shoot will start to generate, and all the step will go on. This is the morphological stages of somatic embryo development in alfalfa, okay, which is a cereal. Now roots of somatic embryogenesis. There are two routes of somatic embryogenesis: direct embryogenesis, and another one is the indirect embryogenesis. The direct embryogenesis means the embryo initiates directly from explants in the absence of any callus formation. So direct formation of embryo from the explants. And second stage, which is in indirect embryogenesis, callus is an intermediate which is formed from the explant, then from the callus the embryo is formed. So in this second stage, we are going through three stages: explant, then callus, then embryo. But in the very direct stage, we are having explant directly to the embryo. Now the types of embryogenic cells. There are pre-embryogenic determined cells, or PEDCs, or sometimes are induced embryogenic determined cells. Normally, the type of embryogenesis that are utilized in laboratories or in vitro conditions are IEDCs, or induced embryogenic determined cells. Okay, so in majority of the cases this is utilized. Specific growth regulator concentrations or cultural conditions are maintained for the development of the callus, and from the callus we need to maintain the callus for some time to grow and divide the callus into a particular extent, then take the callus and put them into the embryogenetic medium and give all the necessary optimum conditions, physiological conditions like temperature, pH, light content and moisture and all these things, and then it will divide and produce the embryo. Okay, and in case of the direct embryogenesis, in case of pre-embryogenic determined cells, these cells are destined to produce embryo, right? So they are committed for the embryonic development. So they do not need the outsource of different chemical components, but they can go on. Okay. Now this is direct somatic embryogenesis. Now in direct somatic embryogenesis, the embryos are formed directly from a cell or small group of cells without the production of an intervening callus. As you can see, no callus is formed. Direct formation of embryo from the explant. It is a rare comparison with the indirect somatic embryogenesis. Now this is the steps of direct embryogenesis. So this is the explant. from the explant we produce the culture. We culture the explant for several time in the medium. We produce a differential mass of cells. Then embryos are formed because this type of cells are destined to produce embryos. So we do not need to go through the process of callus formation. It will direct produce the embryos, or the cells which are destined to produce embryos. Then these cells will mature. And for this maturation we must supply all those necessary ingredients for the embryonic development, and the maturation is done. After the maturation, germination occurs, then the complete plant can be obtained. And these are the example of direct somatic embryogenesis. Now somatic embryogenesis has been reported in many plants, such as the coffee arabica, alfalfa, Daucus carota, and all these different types of plants. Now you can see leaves, hypocotyl nucleus and embryonic sac, etc., can be utilized as the egg, as the sac. So leaf can be utilized, so it's easier to handle. Hypocotyls can be utilized, and also embryonic sacs can be utilized in this case. Okay, so this is the direct embryogenesis seen in case of cassava, as you can see. So this is the peanut somatic embryogenesis. So this is the embryo, this is the peanut embryo. Remember, this is the peanut and this is the embryonic region. So this is the embryo which is collected, put into the medium, and then the cell will start to divide and grow, because this is destined to produce the embryo. So it formed the embryos, then the embryo is developed, and then the embryo is transferred to the culture media, supplying all the necessary ingredients for supporting the growth and maturation of the embryo, and finally the tree is formed. Okay. Now this is the indirect somatic embryogenesis. In indirect somatic embryogenesis, callus is first produced from the explants, and then from the callus other plants are produced. Embryos can then be produced from the callus tissue and from the cell suspension produced from the callus. Okay, so this is the callus suspension of tobacco. From the callus the tree is getting generated, as you can see in this case. So this is an example of indirect somatic embryogenesis. As in this case, the cells are not destined to produce embryos, but we need to induce them to form embryos. This is the step-by-step process. We have explant, culture the explant in the medium, then the callus is formed. From the callus we instigate the callus to produce embryo, adding different inducing agents like hormones, mostly like 2,4-D, IBA, sometimes also NA, and we also give cytokines and other hormones to produce embryo. And the timing of hormones, because the hormonal regulation is important, so the timing is very, very important. An embryo is produced, and the embryo is then further mature. And after the maturation, germination takes place, and the complete plant can be obtained. Example of direct indirect somatic embryogenesis. Now secondary phloem of carrot, leaf tissue of coffee and asparagus, etc., in majority of the cases embryogenesis is thought indirect. Normally it is going through the indirect method, because the cells we have taken for the embryogenesis most of the time are not destined to produce embryo, so we need to instigate them to produce and go with the somatic embryogenesis. Now these are the steps involved in the indirect somatic embryogenesis. Remember again, explant is produced, then callus formation, suspension culture, the cells then start to grow, torpedo shape, heart shaped, first will be the globular stage, then heart shaped, then the torpedo stage, and finally the mature plant. This is again another picture, don't need to learn this. This is another picture, so it's a lot of picture actually coming out. So again, asymmetric division is, you can see, form indirect. That means it's a representative of direct and indirect. So this is the direct one. So in case of direct somatic embryogenesis, remember this is the cell, and it will grow and produce embryo. Then from the embryo it produce the globular embryo. But for the indirect embryogenesis, the cell what we have taken are not destined to form embryo, so they will form the undifferentiated mass of cells which are called the callus. From the callus it will produce a globular shaped embryo, because when you put this callus onto the embryonic development medium or embryonic instigated medium, it will produce this globular shaped embryo. Then the embryo is further matured into globular shape, then heart shape, then torpedo shape, and finally the embryo is matured. Okay. So general rule for any induction of somatic embryo: a high auxin concentration is often required for the development. Gibberellins and ethylenes usually inhibits the embryogenesis. Remember these things. In my previous lecture I have told that gibberellin is important. Gibberellin is important during the normal seed germination process, but it will block the somatic embryogenesis. There lies the paradox. Okay, so remember this. High auxin concentration helps, but not that much high, because much high concentration will prevent the growth of auxiliary bud. Okay, prevent the growth of apical bud. And and also callus from juvenile plant are more efficient for the embryogenesis. Okay, so these are the some features about the embryogenesis or somatic embryogenesis. And also reduced nitrogen in form of ammonium ions can be an important factor for the embryogenesis. Light generally promotes embryogenesis. High temperature favorable for the embryogenesis or somatic embryogenesis. Abscisic acid, which is also important for the embryogenesis. So the hormones that are important for embryogenesis are auxins and abscisic acid. Hormone that are bad for embryogenesis is somatic embryogenesis is gibberellin, and the temperature and the physiological conditions that are favoring the situation is high temperature and high light conditions, and also the reduced nitrogen in the form of ammonia. So these things are important for the somatic embryogenesis. Okay, now the physiological state of the plant from which the explant is taken is extremely important, because if the plant or if the part of the explant which we introduce to produce the embryogenesis or to go through the embryogenesis is somehow diseased or some it's not healthy, then the embryogenesis could be affected. Okay, factors associated in the somatic embryogenesis. Factors like media components is important, light and temperature is also important, light intensities are important, and the wavelength are also important. Exudates are important, and the timing of light, that means the duration at which the plants are getting light, is also important in all kind of plant tissue culture. Okay, extracts like tomato, banana, yeast and coconut water is also important. Coconut water is supposed to support many rounds of somatic embryogenesis in many different plants. Okay, so these natural components are also important. Other constituents like the dissolved oxygen is important. The effect of carbon source can influence the osmotic value. Okay, and also activated charcoal is reported to increase the embryogenesis. So these are some experimental manifestations. Okay, so now let us talk about the difference between the zygotic and somatic embryo. So in both the cases, these are the variables, like the somatic embryo is formed by sporophytic cells, whether the zygotic embryo forms by the fertilized eggs or zygote. Somatic embryo is covered by no covering, and zygotic embryo has the seed coat. Somatic embryo is only the form of embryo, but zygotic embryo is embryo with seed. That means it is having the embryo, the cotyledons, and also it is having the endosperm, and then the seed coat, and finally it is having the seed. But in case of somatic embryogenesis, it is only the embryo, nothing else. Somatic embryo is very weak because it is just an embryo, so it is very weak for taking care of itself. But in case of zygotic embryogenesis, it is coated with seed and all these things, so it is healthy and it is nourished, and it is harsh, it is also stress resistant. Okay, somatic embryo is just like the mother plant, but in case of zygotic embryo, it's not at all like the mother plant all the time, because it's a mixture of mother and father phenotypes, right? Mother and father genotypes, also the phenotype expression as well as the genotype expressions can vary. Okay, but the somatic embryo is just like the mother plant. Okay, but the propagation rate of somatic embryogenesis is very, very high. There lies the importance of doing somatic embryogenesis over zygotic embryogenesis. And on the other hand, zygotic embryogenesis reproduction rate and propagation rate is comparatively low. Okay, so these are the various stages of embryogenesis. This is the zygotic embryogenesis. This is the somatic embryogenesis. From the single cell, cell aggregate, globular stage, heart-shaped, torpedo stage, cotyledonary stage, then the germination. Again, in case of developmental stage of zygotic embryo, globular stage, heart-shaped, torpedo-shaped, then the mature, and then production of the embryo. So these are the differences. You can see here. So this is the undifferentiated cells, and so these are the varying part. In all the cases, both of the regions are the same, except for that in zygotic embryo we are having all these cotyledons, we are having the seed coat, and we are having the endosperm reserved. But in case of somatic embryogenesis, we don't have access to this endosperm as well as the seed coat. Okay. Somatic embryos formation from cell to suspension culture, it is given in this way. We have already discussed this before, so I'm not going to talk about that. So this is the process of somatic embryogenesis utilizing carrots. So you take a carrot, cut a piece of the carrot, took the cells, put them onto the medium, produce the callus. Callus of the carrot is produced, then you take them and spin them. As a result, cells will come into the suspension. Take the suspension, put them onto another culture media where it will help the development of embryo and nourish the embryo. Embryo is formed, then the embryo is transferred into the regeneration media. Regeneration of plant shoot and root is developed, and fully mature plant is produced. Now, what are the advantages of using suspension culture in somatic embryogenesis? In liquid medium, embryogenic tissue is covered in the media so that the tissue gets more nourishment because it is filled with liquid, right? So from all the surroundings, it can derive the nutrients and it can grow rapidly. Because we need rapid division, this is a very important technique. And embryos can be formed in suspension culture in large numbers, and so production can afford a very rapid means of plant propagation. Okay. Now, advantages of somatic embryogenesis is higher propagation rate. It is suitable for suspension culture. It is also is a high propagation rate. This is the most important part. Remember, in somatic embryogenesis, the propagation rate is very, 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 very high. It is suitable for any kind of suspension culture. It is somaclonal variation can be done. Also, germplasm preservation can be utilized utilizing this somatic embryogenesis. So we can preserve the germplasm for long time storage, and also labor saving and all these things. Artificial selection or synthetic seed production can also be done utilizing this somatic embryogenesis. Without the endosperm, a limited shelf life, so no protective seed coat that can right this condition. So in this case, what we can do, we produce this embryo and we coat them utilizing the chemical seed coat, and then we can take them as the chemical seed, or you can tell them as the synthetic seeds. Okay, so this is the schematic presentation showing the artificial synthetic seed production. This is the cultured cell. Take the cell, and from here we can get the somatic embryo. We go through the process of somatic embryogenesis. This is a developed somatic embryo. We take the developed somatic embryo and we do the encapsulation. Now in encapsulation, we add all those chemicals. Different types of chemical salts are added to produce this a coat on surrounding the somatic embryo, which is a synthetic coat, and this coat then finally produces the somatic seeds. Now these seeds, when you put them onto the soil, it can germinate and produce mature plants. Okay, so here this is the diagrammatic presentation of haploid production through the somatic embryogenesis, as you can see. Okay, through the anther culture. Okay, so you take the anther and put the anthers into the nutrient media. Anther is start to grow and produce the embryo. Now you take the embryo and it produce the cell. We can go through two measures. Either these anthers directly produce embryos. Sometimes this anther can produce callus. Now if they produce callus, we go through the indirect mode of embryogenesis. If it directly produce the embryos, we can go through the direct mode of embryogenesis. Okay. Now, what are the disadvantages of somatic embryogenesis? Response to tissue specific. So all the time you cannot go with the somatic embryogenesis. This is tissue specific. For some plant, from the leaf we can go through the somatic embryogenesis. In other plants, a leaf cannot work. Okay, so these are the pros. And inability to generate large number of normal free living plant is also apart. Barriers to high frequency plantlet production may occur at any of a number of points between the induction and the production of plantlets capable of surviving transfer of ex vitro condition. That's another important part. Actually, this is the part we can follow for any kind of procedure of plant tissue culture. But the main problem is that it is restricted to few species, and also it's a response of tissue specificity. Okay. So it may also include low frequency embryo production, that can also be done. And the somatic embryos are not that much healthy, so they are much prone to damage as they are not coated with any seed coat. They are much prone to different environmental stress and environmental damages. Okay, so these things are also bad things. Incomplete embryo maturation can be take place, and it can produce the low latent cell, all these things. Okay, so these are the problems about somatic embryogenesis. This is the references from H.C. Chawla, and you can follow these books. Chawla is a very, very good book for this plant tissue culture, and I hope this will help you. Thank you.